Well, welcome, welcome, welcome. It's been a long time. It's been a long time. Hello, JUZZGORGEOUS TV. Hello, everybody. This is Marie Ollie, your host. And guess what? Today is Wisdom Wednesday, and we are talking about a topic that is quite controversial. It is also going to raise many eyebrows and eye rolling and all that good stuff. But guess what? It's definitely a topic that we need to discuss. And the answer is not going to come from this mouth. It's going to come from this word. The Bible, y'all. So anyhow, first of all, I just want to say thank you all for those who continuously follow JUZZGORGEOUS TV. As you all know, we try to share as much information, news, things that we don't hear about, things that are not about, and things that are being hidden about. But anyhow, today it is Wisdom Wednesday, and we are going to go to the topic of, can a woman be a pastor of a church? Okay, and I am going to answer you with a couple of scriptures. Matter of fact, I have tons of scriptures. Yes, I've got loaded information, but let me go ahead and give you a background before I go ahead and answer the question, if a woman can be a preacher of the word. Gosh, this hair is like driving me nuts. But anyhow, woo, isn't this amazing? First of all, really quick background, okay? The reason why I have to talk about this specific topic, because as of July 2016, I surrender 100% of my life to the Lord Jesus. And no, I'm not a baby Christian. And no, I'm not a newbie Christian. I was born into the church. I've been to many, many churches, always seeking for the truth, always looking for the truth. But guess where I never looked? I never looked into the Bible, never read the Bible, only knew a few, you know, scriptures and whatnot. And where we were raised, we always had to memorize scriptures, but there was no conviction. It was kind of like, you know, just reading, just like you open up a manual when you're a new employee and you read the manual and you do what you're supposed to do, right? Anyhow, so 2 years ago, I wanted to become an ordained minister. I wanted to be a pastor because when I gave my life to the Lord, when he saved this wretched soul of mine, I was like, Lord, thank you so much for saving me. I'm going to go out there and preach your gospel. I'm going to tell everybody about you. I don't care about the cost, no matter what's going to cost me. I'm going to tell everybody about Jesus, and I'm just going to preach your word. I am just going to add souls to your kingdom like there is no tomorrow, because there are not enough men out there doing their job. And, you know, I mean, all these things went in my head. And then of course I have some amazing friends who are female ministers or pastors or preachers or whatnot, and I just love them and they inspired me. And I'm like, I'm gonna go out there, I'm gonna study the word. And you know, of course, according to Revelation, we can't add nor take away. Okay, so to my dismay, my husband's a part of a men's prayer line, and of course he put me up on prayer requests. And then one of the brothers on there say, bro, did you say your wife was trying to become a pastor, trying to become ordained? And my husband says, yes, you know, she's studying really hard, you know. And my husband came home and said, honey, did you know this? And I said, what? Are you telling me that I can't preach the word? Says who? Who says I cannot preach the word? So since I was already in the book of Ephesians, I was in Genesis. I mean, I went through the whole creation, you know, side of the Old Testament, all the way up to Deuteronomy, Leviticus, and I was learning about spiritual warfare and all this stuff. And then I had to go to Ephesians and look at the Godhead. And then I came to Timothy, 1 Timothy. And then I came to 1 Corinthians, and I'm like, what? Now, mind you all, I am a public speaker. I am a lifestyle coach. I am an entrepreneur. I have a voice. When I believe in something, I'm going to stand up and speak. Okay? I'm going to speak on truth. And when I learned throughout this 66 volumes in here, has nowhere that tells me that I can be a pastor of a church, I cried my eyeballs out. You have no idea. I was mad. I was angry. I was pissed. I said, Lord, I know you did not save me to not speak. Are you serious? And I'm like, I know I'm combing through your word, Lord. I know I'm combing through your word, but what are you talking about? Trust and believe. In the book of Matthew chapter 6, it talks about you need to go into your closet and pray. Well, I was in my closet crying for the whole week because I'm like, this cannot be. I am a speaker. I am vocal. I am bold, and I will contend on the truth. So I was very, very upset, pissed off, I should say, that I could not be an ordained minister. I went combing through the 66 books. Let me tell you all, ladies, I went looking for a pinky hole of a somewhere in the scripture that says, oh yes, I can speak. Oh yes, according to the word, I can preach. Oh yes, I can be a pastor. I looked and I couldn't find none. And let me go ahead and start off with the book of 1 Peter, chapter 3, verse 1 through 2, and I use the King James. It's the most accurate Bible there is. In the book, in the NIV version, a lot of words has been changed, and this is where I believe the confusion came from, okay? 1 Peter, chapter 3, verse 1 through 2. Likewise, ye wives, be in subjection to your own husbands, that if any obey not the word, they also may without the word be won by the conversation of the wives, while they behold your chaste conversation coupled with fear. Okay, I'll come back to that. In 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 11 through 14, it says, let the woman learn in silence with all subjection. But I suffer not a woman to teach nor to usurp authority over the man, but to be in silence. For Adam was first formed, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman being deceived was in the transgression. I'll also include all the scriptures in this video just in case some of you joined and did not see that. And first and foremost, don't be angry with me. If you've got questions, please take it up with the Bible. Please go to the Holy Spirit. Please ask God for revelations, okay? To let you know that the word that is written, it is infallible. It is. It truly is. You have no idea how liberating the gospel of Jesus Christ is. Okay, so next biblical scripture. 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 2 reads, a bishop then must be blameless, the husband of one wife. Vigilant, sober, of good behavior, given to hospitality, apt to teach. Okay. 1 Timothy 3, verse 12 and 13. Let the deacons be the husbands of one wife, ruling their children and their own house as well. For they that have used the office of a deacon will purchase to themselves a good degree and great boldness in the faith which is in Christ Jesus. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 34, 36, it reads, let your women keep silence in the churches, for it is not permitted unto them to speak, but they are commanded to be under obedience. As also says the law. And if they will learn anything, let them ask their husbands at home, for it is a shame for women to speak in the church. What? Came the word of God out from you, or came it unto you only? Okay, and this is Titus chapter 1, verse 6, 7. I am sure that you get the point. There are many, many scriptures. I've got notebooks loaded because I was looking and searching for the truth of how I can be a preacher and how I can go and pastor and how I can go and just win souls for the kingdom of God. But women, let there be no mistake. You are very critical. You have a critical role in the kingdom of God. And this is where the enemy has come to steal, kill, and destroy. Because we have lost our way and lost our roles in the kingdom of God. That does not mean we are not equal. Of course, God created us equal. But our roles of responsibility, of authority is different. And this is where many, many people misconstrued and miss, you know, the perception and the way they perceive things is all wrong. And you know what? The Lord says, be quick to listen and slow to speak, okay? Men and women are equal, but our roles of responsibility and authority in the kingdom of God are different. In the book of Genesis chapter 2, God created man from dust, and he breathed life into Adam's nostril, okay? He was created first. A woman was created by Adam's rib. Yes, by his rib, we were created as his helper. Do you know what a helper means? It does not mean doormat, okay? It does not mean slave. We are the helpers to our husbands, and we are the one that are to teach our husbands and our children and raise our families in the gospel of Jesus Christ. Do you not know what has taken place throughout the centuries or the 20th century and in the last 2,000 years? Women have slowly evolved into roles that men would normally play, right? Yes, I mean, we have leadership roles out in the corporate world, out in certain areas. I mean, the word is the word. What is written, it is written. But women need to understand that the powerful role that we play starts at home by us raising our sons in the kingdom of God for them to grow up and go and preach the gospel. But we're raising our kids to become football players, to become all this. Oh, wait, I don't want nobody to get all pissed off at me, okay? I'm just using that as an example. We need to raise up our men, our boys, to become pastors, to be preachers, for them to go out and become disciples and share the gospel of Jesus Christ. And women, our role is to minister to our men. We fill them up with information. And yes, we are to know the word because we can teach women. We can mold our children, our young women. I am not saying this. This is not my word. By all means, please. I cannot take credit for what the gospel, and here are many justification out there. Well, you know, the Old Testament, the reason why they didn't have any female pastors is because, you know, there weren't enough women to preach the gospel or they weren't educated enough. And I'm sorry, Jesus had 12 disciples and they were all men and there were powerful women that followed him. Mary, the mother of Jesus, Elizabeth, the mother of John the Baptist, and Mary Magdalene, who was a prostitute, whose life was transformed by Jesus Christ. There was Deborah. Everybody said, well, what about Deborah? Deborah was given the authority to call people to battle for God, not to be the head of a church, not to become the Godhead. See, the kingdom of God has an order. There is God the Father. There is the Son. So God the Father is the covering for the Son, who is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the covering of man. And the covering of a woman is man, okay? So woman to man to Jesus, Jesus to the Father God. That is the order. God's kingdom has an organizational chart, y'all. But I'm telling you, women, if you look at our society today, if you look at our culture today, what is going on? We have lost our footing in our homes. We have lost the authority of how strong women are to be. Yes, women are prophetic. Did y'all know that? I mean, Anna in the Bible, Yes, she prophesied. We can prophesy. We can teach. We can share. We can hold gatherings. We can pray. My goodness. Well, one thing that we cannot do that God said is a no bueno is to be a pastor of his church. Because do you not know what God calls his church? His bride. In the book of Revelation, Jesus Christ comes back for his bride. And he clearly says in his scriptures that a woman cannot be the head of his church. And with that being said, ladies, eyebrows are going to be raised, whatnot. I'm telling y'all, trust and believe, I was pissed off in 2016 and 2017 when I was doing all my studies and when I found out that I cannot be on that pulpit. I was mad because that was where my heart was. That's where the desire. But my obedience in the Lord Jesus, I was like, I can't. What can I do? It was kind of like I was looking for an excuse to go out there. If there's anything that I will stand for, is the biblical truth. You can call me whatever you want. It doesn't matter. Because you didn't die for me on the cross. Jesus did. And you're not going to stand for me when judgment day comes. We stand as equals. And when he looks up the book of life, if your name is there, I do not want to be what Jesus says in the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 21, 22, when I'm going to be like, Lord, did I not do these things in your name? Lord, did I not prophesy in your name? Lord, did I not cast out devils in your name? Father God, didn't I do this for you? And he's going to say, depart from me. I never knew you. Ye that work iniquity. Oh my. My desires of being up in that pulpit ain't worth me going to hell for. And heaven and hell is real. It is so real. It is so real. Ladies, we need to take a stand, but a stand in the biblical truth. We need to know our role of what our Father wants us to be. Understand that we have a powerful role. Isn't it amazing that when we speak to our husbands or our children, our sons, they are more inclined to listen to us? Why? Because we're the ones that nurtures them. We're the ones that have given birth to them. So even when Mary, she was behind the scenes, the women that followed Jesus, they were behind the scenes. They ministered to him behind the scenes. They never stepped in front. They stayed behind the scenes. It doesn't matter for people to see us. God sees us. It took me a long time to put this video together because trust and believe, I had to ask the Holy Spirit to guide me. So please don't shoot the messenger because it is not my word. It is his word. I just gave you a few scriptures and there's more. There's more. I cannot go against his word because it is written. It is written. It is written. But ladies, prayer warriors, intercessors, we're the ones behind the scenes to help our families, to help our community, to help our nation. If Esther called on a fast when they were all, her and her people were about to get slaughtered, and God used her at the time such as that to go to her husband, the king, and speak truth. The power of prayer. Okay. Let me tell you, let me just name a few women in the Bible that are absolutely powerful that everybody knows about. There's Deborah, there's Huldah, there's Anna, there's Phoebe, there's Priscilla, there's Miriam, there's Aquila. And then there was even daughters of Philip, I believe, and they prophesied. But you don't hear much about them. Why? Because they were behind the scenes. okay? That were behind the scenes. Ladies, if you even knew your worth and the power you hold, boy, Luke 10:19, he said he gave us authority to step on the heads of serpents and scorpions. Hello? We have a different role. Raise your man up. Minister to your husband. Let them go out. And for us, we need to focus on grooming and sharing the word with all the sisters out there in truth. Contend in love and in truth, because Jesus is the way, the life, and the truth, because his word will set us free, okay? And if you have any questions, I'm going to point you to Jesus about this topic. And I'm going to put all the scriptures that I have for you to do your own research. But please stop justifying his word, because his word is the word. So many of us wants to use justification. Oh, but there are not enough men to preach. Oh, there are not enough men that are speaking. Let me tell you, I know men be going all kinds of cray cray. But this is where we come into play. When we are a woman of God, a woman that fears the Lord shall be praised. And that's Proverbs 31:30. I fear the Lord. And I am going to minister to my husband and to my kids so that he can go out and share the gospel of Jesus Christ while I continue to hold a prayer ministry. We have a women's prayer ministry. Yes, prayer ministry, not a church, y'all. It's called Fearless Women of Faith Prayer Ministry. What do? We pray. We talk about the scriptures. We read a scripture before we pray. That is our job. We pray and we equip, we encourage, we empower women to stand up for the role that God has given them. But do you know your role? It took me a while to find mine, and trust and believe, I was crying like a big baby. And it wasn't cute. I didn't look cute. But anyhow, with that being said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for this opportunity, divine moment. Took me forever to get on here on Juzz Gorgeous TV and share the biblical truth about, can a woman be a pastor of a church? And the short answer is a no, we cannot. Once again, those scriptures are 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 11 through 14, 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 2, 1 Timothy chapter 3, 12 to 13, 1 Corinthians 14, 34 to 36, Titus 1, 6 through 7. Woo! And there are more scriptures, okay? So, Wisdom Wednesday, ladies, God favors us. We have a powerful role to equip our daughters and our sons and our husbands in the biblical truth. May this message bless you. And if it made you upset, good. If it made you pissed off, good. If it made you like you want to knock somebody out, good. This is a time where you need to go and search the truth. Don't believe me. Don't believe any. Search the truth. Okay? So with that being said, this is Marie with Juzz Gorgeous TV on your Wisdom Wednesday. I'll be back here next week. Love you all. Bye.